Okay, so I'm gonna keep going with this cat. And before I flip back to the left side, I'm thinking about these whiskers now. I'm going to mark in okay, so scratch that. I'm gonna get dark sepia and sharpen it really well. And I'm gonna mark in the whisker spots. So we're gonna have to leave some white space for the whiskers. So it's gonna be tricky, but we can do it. So we already kind of marked them in on the left side. So let's do the right side. And then what we'll do is the muzzle. Because I don't want to draw over top of any areas where the whiskers are. And it makes more sense to figure out where the whiskers are coming from if we do the muzzle first. Okay. So there's four right here. Now these are going to be black. I'm just doing them right now. And the sepia because you know how sometimes I have to erase. And it's a smidge easier. I just lost where I was. Something like that. Stand up and take a look. Yeah, I think that's pretty good. Okay. So moving on. Might be a little bit bigger. So I'm not gonna go over these until I'm more confident that they're okay. So that's one, two, three. These are more lines. So the blobs. And then there's a final set down here. Okay. One, two, three. Oh, that one's too far. One, two, three. Yeah. as per usual, me messing up. Mm-hmm. Didn't put a base layer down, did I? Okay. Going over to the other side. I have a lot of pencil marks here, but I don't care because they're kind of helping me. Maybe they're not. Okay, then we got... this line. And the bottom line, which is really just a few marks in between the whiskers. Okay. So some of them start out black, which is nice, but then they end up white at the end. Kitty, why couldn't you have black whiskers? So probably the ones coming up top here, we'll just leave those black and then like black, black, black. So we'll start to worry about this space leaving around here and here. And there's just like a, I don't know, the tail end of two white ones here, which maybe we'll just not worry about them. Okay. So with that, I guess we could do the muzzle. You get to see the scattered inner workings of my brain. So let's do ivory and then like a warm gray one. Over here. Now I'm going to have to be careful because I think I used black right there. So I might just avoid that edge entirely and put warm gray in it. Definitely have to get rid of the pencil marks because this is light. Trying to keep my eye out to make sure when we have to start avoiding things because of the white whiskers. Suppose you could always do a like a masking fluid. I'm just looking at my sketch because I don't even feel like it's right with the base and the chin is way lower. Like, this is the chin down here. Just goes to show you can trace and still not know what the heck you're doing. Alright. I'm gonna have to move my setup. I don't really have enough room. So, let's move. Well, you know what? Let's just go with the warm gray. I'm going to sharpen it. Let's go all the way down to the chin, because that's warm gray. I can go up to the black with this. I feel safe. The warm gray and black. So remember to go in the direction of the fur. I didn't do that part of the muzzle. What do you think, Cozy? Okay, so there are white whiskers coming out of here, but I'm not worried about that because this warm gray is so light. Right, Lakota? He's probably getting irritated with me. Mom, stop working. So the whiskers don't get crazy till like here. There's some black ones here. Okay. Hi, Boo. He's staring at me. Let me just do this last video. Red beige. So I'm not going to go down here with it. Where the white whiskers are. Put it on this side. I mean, really, you were out not that long ago. Barks on me, I'm gonna be in trouble because it's sharp. He's looking at me. Cozy, I can't leave it looking like this. Looks bad. Okay, dark sepia. Let's just put the before I get in too much trouble. Map the mouth in, but we gotta be real sketchy because it's a lot of fur down there. I'm coming. You're like a nag. Okay, this is tricky. Lost my line art, which wasn't right anyway. Not yet, Lacona. So there's some red in here, which is cool. But I'm not going to worry about that right now. Just sketching the upper lip in. So the cat's head is at an angle, so gotta be careful. And I don't want to go over here yet because there are whiskers galore. Okay, so I'm ready to map in the chin. I'm gonna use nougat. So I'm just gonna kinda use the direction of the fur, and then underneath there's also some whiskers. That we're gonna have to start worrying about here. So I mapped in this one really large one. So I think that's this one that's coming from up here and then it goes down. So I'm gonna try and keep that one in here. And I'll just erase the pencil mark. And then there's one near it. But they kind of go like whoosh. So we have to make it make sense. Because the whiskers will be coming all this way. But much like the grass, I'm just going to make the areas too big for now that I'm kind of keeping. You know, it might not be a bad idea to draw some with a pencil super light just to see how they continue. I might do that. So here's our chin. He's got a lot of longer pieces coming down. So I'm really just sketching this in right now. And he's got some curvy, whiskery things right here. So So the chin goes in a little bit. It's the shape of it. And these are little whiskers, so I'm not gonna kill myself with the whiskers. I'm going to just put in some of them. Because that would be insane. Unless you want to do it. Okay, so I had mapped out that this is the bottom of the chin. So the chin, it looks okay to me. And I think this shape makes sense, and I'm kind of tilting my head to make sure it makes sense. Which I think it does. Okay. So I have some whiskers in, which I'm really kind of glad of now. I'm gonna just lighten them a little bit. And then I'm going to put some in, just real light. Because this type of paper, so you couldn't do this on pastel mat, because you can't erase pencil on pastel mat. So I learned the hard way. Don't put your sketch in pencil on pastel mat, because you can't erase it. So unless you're going to cover it up completely, maybe with some pastels or something. But this kind of paper, you can erase pencil, so that's good. I don't know what this is over here. So I'm going to get rid of it. For me, it's about keeping the lines as long as I can, so that I can see them. Okay, over here I have the edge of his cheek, his muzzle. So I'm gonna keep that. And then this is like that big fluff coming out to the side, which makes sense because we put that there. It's nice when it makes sense, I feel like. Okay, I'm gonna go get a pencil. Okay, I went and got a H pencil and I sharpened it. So I have a, I'm gonna move this iPad out of my way. I have some mechanical ones, which would probably be good, but I don't know. I don't know where the heart or lead is. I won't be able to see that. It's kind of got a curve in it. I don't know that any of these lines are helpful. Sometimes I just get so impatient with wanting to start a drawing, I really scribble down the outline. Okay, so I'm not going to put all of them in, just some. kind of nice to be able to erase the whiskers. Whiskers are, they're scary for me because, you know, you've spent hours on a drawing and then you can really mess it up when you do the swoops, which, you know, we'll have to do with some of the black ones. Must have courage. Okay. So my plan is, we'll see if this works, to, this one was here and I kind of got rid of it too much. Just work around these lines and leave a space with the, like, don't go over them with the color pencil. Leave a space and then erase, you know, in the early layers, and then erase the graphite before we add more layers. So we'll see if this works. Some people, I think, do like the gel pens. Just trying to think of different ways you can do whiskers. Gotta do some up here. This one's kind of going straight. So I just use them as a guide. I'm not trying to do them exact. Like if you were using a grid. That one too wacky. That's better. So the black ones are coming out of the top. Probably gotta put one more right here. Something like that. I feel like you have to have some whiskers for a cat. That and that. In the picture it goes like that. We can go over these if we want, if it's too much. Swoops up. Okay, that's good, that side. This has a good amount here. Maybe just something going like this. Some of these are from the top rung. See that. I think whiskers are one of those things that you get better the more often you do them. I'm not saying I'm that great at them, 'cause I'm not. So these are black. They end in white. On the other side, you don't get to see where they end in white, which is nice. I think I did that already. This is really coming from up here. We have a lot of noisy birds. I don't know if you can hear them. It's often the mockingbirds. They're so funny. I see them like fighting outside. It's a pretty cool adaptation. I feel like to have used other birds. Calls. Okay, I'm not gonna bother with these. Let's just make sure. I think that's okay. What do you think? Got some down here. Where is that? So this is too long. So is that? Little patch right here. Alright, so I'm just going to use that as markers to preserve. Let's see how this works. Need some coffee for that. Okay, snoot. Look at that blob right there. Okay, got rid of that. So I think I'll just kind of refine this, get my iPad back. Zoom in a little bit. Focus on right around the nose. So, I was working on this last evening, so to be honest with you, I don't quite remember what I put on there. So I'm going to put some ivory, warm gray, red beige, which we probably already started. But I'm just going to go ahead and take that out through here, avoiding my pencil lines. It looks like I already did it over here, didn't I? Doesn't hurt to have some more. And I got scared right there with good reason because of the whiskers. So then maybe warm gray 2. Actually, let's do warm gray 1. Might want to put some cream in. It's kind of yellowy right here. Doesn't hurt to have this warm gray 1 everywhere on the muzzle. You would think I would have. I should have one of those lines moving up. Okay, that one will do. Gonna put the warm gray 1 down here too. One time we had a mockingbird that was so annoying. It was like the beginning of mating season, and he would sit on top of the chimney so then we could hear him at all hours. Just sing and sing and sing, but I think he finally got a lady and settled down. Get that cream. So this cream I think is a lot more yellow than the Prismacolor cream. I really don't use it unless something has some kind of strong yellow. It's almost like a lemony color. A little bit here. There's some over there, but I haven't gotten over there yet. Maybe here. Trying to think. Maybe probably like the same suspects, Beaster and Nougat and Burnt Sienna. I think I'll start with the Burnt Sienna. Just gonna try and lightly get some lines in here. Not sharp. I feel like I'm not very sharp. Wow, my pencil. It's kind of orangey up here. And here, and this kind of goes down. Oh, try not to sneeze. This one's kind of darker right there. Should probably use Nougat right there. Looks like it's light, but it needs to have fur lines here. I'm gonna sharpen my Nougat. Probably use like a warm gray too to add some texture. So this blobby blob kind of goes down. Gonna get hard to see those whiskers I drew in. probably put some cinnamon in. Some Beester. So that looks pretty sharp. Especially over here. Sharpening it. Especially down here. Gonna put some more warm gray one. Just broke. On top to kind of blend a little bit. Gotta be careful I don't go too dark. See, I'm not really loving that cream over here. It's just not my favorite color. Too yellow. I think I'm going to use the dark sepia to darken the spots. Try to get it really sharp. I'll put some black on here eventually. So I'm trying to make some lines because if you really look, it's not a full black circle. So that'll make it look more realistic if you can capture that. And down here, it's definitely less of a shape, or less of a circle shape, I guess. Darken right here too while I'm at it. There's some tiny, tiny little dark sepia lines right here. Sharpen it again. These are a little bit whack right here, but see if I can fix that. Back to, what should I do right here? Maybe let's do some burnt ochre, sharpen it. So I definitely see some more of that around this edge of the nose and under here. Some orange here. Back to the burnt sienna. Just want to darken some of my fur lines. Whoa, that really darkened, didn't it? That's not really red right there. That's gray. Kind of brown and gray. I don't know. We haven't used umber. Considering burnt umber. Let's do it. I'm gonna find it though. I did put my pencils back away last night. Helps a little bit. So, this is what I was looking at. This upper area. Yeah, that's a good color for that. Okay. Maybe just a little into this. This is almost like dark sepia right in there. That whole little cluster is kind of dark. See if I can just put some spots. Okay. I'm gonna get some red beige and put it over here because I'm unhappy about my cream situation. Remind me next time, that's not my fave. This needs more color. That's lacking something. Okay. Some warm gray one to blend. Nougat. Okay. trying to go in between the whiskers down here, just trying to get the shape of the muzzle in. Which is quite tricky right there. Quite tricky. The whiskers. Okay, I want to make sure I have a warm gray everywhere down here, so if I do need to erase, which I'm going to, it'll be easier. I'm going to put this down before I get rid of that pencil line. Kind of looking at it. On this side. So I'm going to go with the nougat again and get my eraser. So, did I put the warm gray right there? I just want to map this piece in so I can make sure the shape is right. So there's that piece right there. It goes up. So there's a little bit of a buffer between the outside of the muzzle and the whisker dots. I'm sure they're not called whisker dots. Just what I'm going to call them right now. Kind of orangey right here, but this will do for now. And this is what we put in before. It's fine. the fur's kind of going this way. It's hard to do with the whiskers. Okay, that's pretty rough. Rough outline. It does help. Helps to do that. It's easy to get lost in kitty fur. So, like that, and then that's probably good. Just looking for my edge here, the edge of the muzzle. I think that's okay. And up here. Something like that. So you see how you can erase a little bit better if you have something underneath. Okay. Shape. This is probably down a little bit too much. So we have that. It's like a cooler, well, I guess it's warm gray, but it's pretty light down here. For his little chin. Okay. Gonna get my nougat again, make sure it's sharp, which I think it is. So under the lips, it's nougat, but it's also like warm gray. I'm gonna do warm gray 5 to try and differentiate it more. Nice and sharp. So for this one, I'm gonna try and do some lines and preserve some white areas. You see how there's little white lines under there too. And we can put some kind of a pinky color. There's like a, I don't know, maybe a caput mortuum or something. That's here, that's showing the kind of the pink lip that's under the fur. Moving everywhere, it's hard to make sure I have the camera in the right spot. Okay. I feel like this is one of those areas that you just want to hurry and get it finished, but then it will look so much better if you take your time. I have to kind of remind myself to slow down. Because you could just hash this whole muzzle in if you wanted. Trying to show how there's hairs coming down from the top too. I just want every one of my whisker lines. My glycine paper. That's okay, I'm at the bottom anyway. Might have pulled his lip down a little bit too far. Let's see if I can fix that. That's like a blob. I don't know, I had a piece of pigment there and it very stubborn. Okay. So now I'm just gonna use a little nougat. Trying to outline the bottom chin better. Sharpen my pencil. So I'm just using nougat to try and map it in. So I just kind of gently map things in and then darken it once I see they're right. And then if I don't think they're right, if there's that layer underneath, then I can kind of erase a little bit. Then even if something's not great, then it's okay, because I can just make it work. Right now I'm just trying to get those whisker lines back in. Okay. So this little like chin shelf is not that long. And then it switches to some other crazy stuff going on down there. Moving my pencil up so that it looks like kind of mimics the lines going up. Okay, so let's put some more dots in here. This is going to go in a little bit. Let's work on this side, and then we'll continue to build it up kind of as a piece. So I'm going to put some more light blush on it. I mean red beige. Especially down here. And then let's see what we can do with some cinnamon, especially around the nose. And I'll put some orange there too. Burnt sienna, sharp pencil, and light strokes. Fur kind of takes a turn and starts going up that way. See some here. You can tell when you get on a spot where it doesn't have a lot of pencil because it. Oh, I just broke that. Because it goes down a lot easier. Which can be good or bad. This is pretty orangey right here, I feel like. Okay, so this is more What is that? Beaster? Beaster Sharp. Yeah, that's pretty good. You can tell there's a bunch of layers here because you have to go over it a few times to get it to go down. I think I'm going to go do a little Beaster over here too, because that looks pretty good for some very light shadows. Okay, let me see what's going on here. So it looks like this part has a little bit darker. Okay. Gonna try and keep these whiskers, these cursed whiskers. But not right there, because they're black. Thank the Lord, we have a few. Just take your wins where you can get them. I'm gonna put some more shadows on that side. Okay. So then, so we have that. Don't really have any dark right there that I need. So, dark sepia. I mean, that could be either, that could be the umber too, either one. Oh, God is dreaming. Somebody's always dreaming. Okay, so I gotta be careful right here. These whiskers. Biggie's outside, so you won't hear her dreaming right now. That's what we call Addie. She's big. She's bigger than Lakota. We have a lot of nicknames for both of them. That's probably from my dad. My parents would take care of our dogs when we go away, and I had a my dad, he's passed away now, but so now it's like my brothers will watch them at my mom's house, because Big is too big, and thing pulls. But anyway, so when my dad was around and he would watch them, and he called them Big Poop and Little Poop, but he didn't call them poop. So that's probably where that nickname came from. Big and little. Okay, how about some burnt ochre? Especially around this top of the nose and then here. We're getting it. Slowly. It's kind of orangey right there. Felt like that side was easier. Maybe a little more. Let's see. Well, let's do this a little bit more of this under the lip. So I think the Caput Morton Violet will be good for this part. So I'm going to try and go over some areas that I've already drawn lines over, so that I'm leaving spots. Then we can always glaze over this area to kind of show that there's a shadow. You know, the light hairs won't be that light, but it's easier to leave them right now like that and then darken them. Make sure I don't go too crazy with it. Can't undo that. Try and remember, you can always add more. Patience, this medium. Okay, so there's a couple little lines coming out here I want to get. Then we can get the individual hairs. What do you think? Warm gray 3, maybe? Here is, well, remember that, I put it over there. Those whiskers. So I'm just going for the shadows here. We can always darken them if we want to. Okay, that's not bad. So we'll have to darken under the lip more. Thinking about a Payne's gray. All the grays look similar when they're standing together in my jar. Okay, so this is really dark in here. House is settling, I guess. Try not to mess up this lip line here. Really like that Payne's gray with the cap and ward on. That's pretty. I use a cold gray 3 to kind of. I don't know. Like blend it out. Does that make sense? Make it so it's not such a harsh transition between the panes. Like this line is a little aggressive. That's okay. Probably soften it with the old Caran d'Ache. Sometimes you gotta make sure it doesn't have another color on the bottom of it. That's okay. I'm going to use a little more of this cap it. So just put some kind of, I see little dots, real faint. And then some black. Sharpen it though. So some of this is black. And then here in the middle, it's really dark, which will be a good contrast. Okay, I'm gonna leave it like that for now, and then we can always darken it. It's better to be safe than sorry, I always say. Okay, so this side needs a little bit, well, they probably both do, but a little bit more refinement. Maybe though, hold on, let's do... Raisin warm gray 3. I might use a little warm gray 4 in the chin for some shadows, and then scrub over it some warm gray 2 or 3. I know it's light, and I guess I don't want to darken it too much, but it looks too light right now. I do not know where my warm gray 4 is. Right there. So I'm just going to go over some of the shadows that I already did. There's kind of shadows going out. I've been avoiding. This area is rough right here because the whiskers are going like this, and then the fur is actually going this way. It's pretty tricky. Maybe the warm gray 1. there's kind of that brown ochre color right there. Or Beaster. Let's go brown ochre. That's green gold. Don't want that. It's coming where these hairs are. I'm gonna put it over here too. And I add it everywhere. Oh, I don't want to do that. Maybe I was thinking about refining that chin a little bit more. What is the nougat? Seems to be the perfect color for it. Do we have anything down there? I don't remember. Probably should. Warm gray one. Okay, I had to take a break because, I don't know, it's hard and it helps me to get up every now and then. So now I'm ready to tackle the muzzle some more. Okay. So we just put the warm gray one in here, so now I'm gonna use this Beaster to kind of map out these shadows that are over here. So we'll have, let's see, some black whiskers going like that. Yeah. I think it goes in a little further. Let's see. Maybe. Cozy. Is that really cleaning himself like a kitty cat? I just fed them and Addie's outside. Sometimes she likes to eat outside. She's so funny when she's out there and she doesn't want to come in. She won't come near the door, so I just leave the food there. She's like, don't make me come in. I think when I did that, I put that a little bit too far down, but it's okay. So, I need to put the side of his cheek in. This is dark sepia. And we made a whisker here. So I'm gonna go around it. Okay. So this needs to come in a little bit more. So I'll get the nougat. I just ate a protein shake. It made me pretty cold. So I'm just going to take these marks up a little bit. My beaster. Just want to kind of smooth that a little bit. Beast would probably be good for this. That piece is pretty warm. Okay. Gonna put maybe that burnt umber and sharpen it, and then just put some more shadows in the muzzle. I think that's a good color for that. Probably need some, I don't know, dark sepia in there too. But I'm going to go back to the other side. Well, hold on, I'm going to do this first. Put some here. Okay, so I think some dark sepia shadows in the muzzle. So I'm just looking for where is it really dark. And then on this side, okay, so now I'm going to do the black and then go over the spots again, because I kind of got lost with my darker shadows. This part down here is kind of weird, so I'm going to lay off till we can refine it a little bit later. Kind of save the black, I do, until I feel pretty confident about it. Just harder to erase, harder to fix if you make a mistake with it. Won't go crazy down there either. So I think this needs to be darker. I thought I was gonna swipe something over that, wouldn't I? Did I do that? Okay. Kitty, kitty. So the edges of the muzzle and the chin, they need more work, but I'm going to wait what I did right there.
Cozy Co. Alright. So, I think now... So, this isn't done. But it's okay. It's okay. Looks pretty good. I'm going to move over to this side. And then work on this. Add some layers. And then continue to build this whole bottom part. Kind of together, I guess. So... Oh man, there's some more green down there. We don't have to do that if we don't want. I think I'm gonna leave that part out. I'm not gonna put green. Maybe just like some sepia over there. Okay, so on the edge it's lighter. I'm just gonna ivory the whole thing on the edge. And then, like, just warm gray. So I'm just going to continue this part with ivory. Just a little bit lighter. But then I'm going to do warm gray one. Over the rest of it. That's a safe base for this cap. Just gonna try and leave a little bit of space around this whisker. This is a really light section of his fur, so we're not gonna see that whisker very much anyway. But I guess it's where the black one and then it turns white. I don't think I need that pencil on, so I'm gonna get rid of it. sharpen it again. I think what happens is the piece of the pigment breaks off and then it gets trapped in the tooth of the paper when I go over it. It's kind of aggravating. More pencil lines. I can get rid of. Yes, Lakota, that's your sister barking. She just likes to bark sometimes. I'm going to go ahead and take this all the way to the other side. I'm sure you can't see. I can sort of see where I've colored over. Just want a base layer so then we can work wherever we want around the face. I think it'll be easier to judge the values in the face if we work on this bottom part at the same time. Kind of build it all up together. Here in between some of these whiskers. coat of hair. Like floats in the air. It's very soft. Fluffy like a cat. It's like part cat. He also doesn't like people. He only likes his people. I don't know if that's like a cat, because sometimes cats don't even like their people. Almost. Almost there. Probably did some here, but I can't remember. Okay. So back to the left side. Okay, so I think the best thing to do is to put in some darker marks. Let's see. This is when my iPad isn't as helpful as my reference photo, because the picture on my iPad is bigger. Because I tripped it. Sorry, I was just yawning. Okay, this is nougat. It's nice and light. Scribble some. So these are those like frizzier hairs. I don't know what that animal's barking at. Oh, she's barking at my neighbor driving in. Okay, so this is like kind of a chunk of fluff right here. So I'm going to leave that. It's kind of light flesh, warm gray, maybe some Beaster. So sometimes I feel like it helps if you squiggle your pencil when you have the frizzier fur. Okay, I'm gonna try and keep this whisker. So right here we have, okay, that done, that going down in there. So this is it's like a little piece, a little tuft. I'm gonna try and outline it. I'm gonna stay kind of closer to the face with this nougat, because things look more gray. Cold gray. Oh, I just lost my photo. The program crashes. open it back up. Get some squiggles in before I have to leave that. So there's dark down here, but I'm gonna put this in first. Ooh, that's tight. Tight for that whisker. Okay, so kind of after this thing, it's more gray. The nougat. So, I think what I'll do now is roughly put in some of this dark so we can keep track of that. So, sepia. We'll use sepia, but use it light. That's not sepia. Light touch. Okay, my photograph isn't in the most ideal spot right now. So this stuff needs to be darker. There's a whisker right there. This is darker than that, but that's okay, we'll continue. This has a little dark to it. Doesn't match up exactly with the photo. That's okay. We're not going for hyper-realism. Okay. So, let me focus here for a minute. So we have this tuft coming out. Darker down here, and then down here, just gonna do kind of a squiggly motion. I'm just gonna look at my picture right now. I'm not doing detail anyway. Oh, I should have done that before. So this is a little low. Should be up here more. Because this down here is different. just darken that. Okay. So that's that. And then you have kind of a swoop right there. It's going to look different anyway because I don't know, I don't have the whiskers where they're supposed to be. Exactly. I'm just trying to mimic that craziness that's going on with that cat's fur. Frizzy bit. And then there's like a tuft. Got some tuft action going on here. So there is, all right, that piece, the dark. There's a tuft. Hair going everywhere. And then oh, it goes over there. Basically, sketching out these shapes. I don't know what that is. An old line? Who knows? I guess I had two right there. I don't know. One, two. Okay. See what I'm doing over here. That is my husband honking at Addie. She gets so excited when people come home. Not bad. That's not bad.